Because you have no heart. If you are in Islam, you are selling your heart.
I can hear it beating in my chest.
What?
My heart beats in my chest clearly, fine.
No, your heart is black. It's
why,
dark.
How do you know? Have
it's
you cut dark. The heart open? Are you a Christian? Are you a Christian?
Yes, I am.
So you believe God impregnated a baby, right?
I believe that you're Muhammad.
Do you believe terrorism is a meaningless buzzword created by white supremacists when brown people fight back? That's what it is. Terrorism means nothing.
Welcome to Audit Oblivion, where we highlight wildest police interactions. You have the right to like, comment, and subscribe. Anything you do can and will help us create more amazing content. Without further ado, let's get into today's video. Welcome to Speaker's Corner, a symbol of free speech nestled in Hyde Park, London. Established in the 19th century, this iconic site has hosted luminaries like Karl Marx, George Orwell, and countless others, transforming it into a global stage for public discourse. Here, the essence of freedom of expression comes alive. Most will agree that words can inspire, provoke, and sometimes boil over. In this video, we will see how freedom of speech can often act as a catalyst, agitating those involved into committing shameful acts. Man, after all, is not flawless.
This guy, he cleans his ass 8 times. But you know what? I clean my heart. You clean your ass eight times. I clean my heart. What is God going to judge? Is he going to judge how clean your butt crack is? Or is he going to judge your heart and your deeds?
Mansoor, ladies and gentlemen, Mansoor, why are you going away? Why?
Because this is what they do. They flee. Yeah. Because they have no defense. Once we start talking about their Muhammad, listen, spread the word.
He needs to be held accountable, this man.
Do you know what happens in prison?
And the rest of these people here who claim now, about
and
Allah,
there's a bunch
Muhammad,
of Muslims there, they will the make you convert to Islam or they will kill you or beat you.
Recent research published by the Commons Library explores data on the UK prison population, including the population size and change over time, and the demographic profile of prisoners. At the end of June 2023, just under half of the prison population was of a Christian faith. The proportion of Muslim prisoners has increased from 8% in 2002 to 18% in 2022.
Having killed in a prison for not converting to Islam.
Do you think
how many people have been killed in a prison for not converting to Islam?
Death is a laughing matter.
How many people have been killed?
Do you think death is a laughing matter?
I have asked you a question.
Do you think death is a laughing matter? Look how he smirks. Look how he smirks.
It's fine to smirk at a crazy person like you. Now, how many people have been killed in a prison?
Says the guy.
You made a claim.
I could drop to your level.
But I haven't. I'm asking you a question.
You'd be elevating yourself.
How many people have been killed in a prison for not conveying to Islam? You made a claim. Bring evidence.
Someone was stabbed in the name of Allah. It was an Iranian journalist.
Israelis are the modern Nazis. It's fine to defend yourself from a Jewish rapist.
Never in your life.
I do not believe Jews should be allowed to rape.
Be quiet.
And you can claim anti-Semitism.
Never in your life. Give your details to a Muslim. This is what they do. I'm going to tell you their intelligence tactic. What they will do is they will go between their mosque giving intelligence. Hey, you know, this happened. This is how they find you.
You're a coward, right?
I just said yes.
Okay, there you go. Thank you.
I don't talk to cowards.
You might poop yourself any minute.
Illiterate.
I don't talk to cowards. You may poop yourself.
You're an illiterate.
Should I read something?
You're learning to love death and violence and hate. Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Coward and a liar.
Coward and a liar.
Coward and a liar.
Low EQ.
In the Muslim heaven.
You have low EQ. All right. You believe in Allah or Muhammad?
Doesn't matter what I believe.
Yes, it does.
Why does it matter to you? You're a coward.
You're making.
It doesn't matter what I believe. You're a coward. Who hides his face? You're not worth my time. You're like some Channel 4 reject from the 90s. You're like Bo Selector. You're Bo Selector, innit? You're both selector.
What are you yourself? What about you?
Doesn't matter what I am.
I don't talk to you
anonymous cowards.
No,
why are you hiding your face? Are you about to commit jihad? Baby, okay. Did you get that? Did you get that? Who heard that? He said, I might be about to commit jihad. Commit jihad right now then. Do it. Do it.
What is jihad?
You just heard it from this guy.
In the United Kingdom, right?
I'm about to commit jihad.
There's a shortage of mentor institutions, so there's no way they can put people like him. So they release him to the streets. This is called public. It's called, I can't remember what the term is, but it's where society deals with the mentally ill people.
The term often used to describe a society controlled by individuals with mental illnesses is pathocracy. This concept was developed by the Polish psychologist Andrzej Wobczewski in his book, Political Ponerology. Pathocracy refers to a form of government or a system of control wherein individuals with severe personality disorders, such as psychopathy, narcissism, or other antisocial personality disorders, attain positions of power and influence, shaping society according to their pathological worldview.
So, basically, the mental hospitals and the institutions, they can't house these people.
The guy
anymore.
With the yellow teeth. You need a dentist,
so
my friend.
Degree in psychology?
Sorry, I have done psychology at university, actually.
Really? Well, you need to do a bit more. You need to do a bit more.
Yeah. So you're mentally ill.
With personal
and
hygiene.
Here this guy screaming and shouting.
With personal hygiene.
What is the hygiene for you when you've been?
I think mental health and personal hygiene.
Why'd you come out? You said you don't want to pee in your ass and now you're worried about my teeth.
Sorry? Because you have no heart. If you are in Islam, you are selling your heart.
I can hear it beating in my chest.
What?
My heart beats in my chest clearly, fine.
Your heart is black. It's
why
dark.
Why do you have
it's
you cut dark. My heart open and see the
you're
color?
You're Muslim. I don't need to look inside.
And where are you?
If you have a heart,
I'm Muslim. I'm proud Muslim. I admit it. Where are you?
No.
Where are you?
If you're asking
can
me
you even
question,
admit what you
why
are? Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Are you a Christian? Are you a Christian?
Yes, I am.
So you believe God impregnated a baby, right?
I believe that you're Muhammad.
Do you believe,
Allah.
Why is your Christian God self-aware when Mary gave birth to him? Simple question.
What are you going to do?
Why is your God self-aware when Mary gave birth to him?
Are you going to send them to your terrorist friends? Is that what you're going to do? So why are you recording me? Look, they even teach the little children to record videos to send them to their little terrorist friends.
Who cares? Terrorism is a meaningless buzzword created by white supremacists when brown people fight back. That's what it is. Terrorism means nothing. All it means is either all political violence is terrorism or none is. When the police attack the women at the Women's March, okay? All right, either that was terrorism or there is no such thing as terrorism. Very simple.
Excuse me. If you're a true Muslim, yes, you would go to Palestine.
My God.
Do the struggle there. Struggle.
There's no, why do you have to go there? I support the IRA. I support the IRA.
No,
I believe in legitimate freedom fighting.
You would go there and do your jihad struggle.
Why do I need your permission?
Because you have an obligation to Allah. You have an obligation. You would go do your jihad in Palestine. And if you die, you go to your Jannah, yes?
And get 72 oranges.
Thank you.
What does it say? Show me where it says that.
I'm asking her. What do you mean?
That's a young girl.
I'm rough. Don't ever touch me.
Bitch.
Yeah!
I see you!
I'm not letting you go.
And this is what happens when people have freedom of expression. More often than not, things escalate. At this point, the police have a difficult job of uncovering the circumstances of the incident.
Leave the car.
No, sir, he attacked. He's talking to
you. Under arrest.
You're not going nowhere. Yeah, yeah, look, he's laughing, the little terrorist cunt.
Come here.
At this point, officers detain the man that was slapped in the face. The perpetrator attempts to escape the scene of the crime. But this is easier said than done, as he is surrounded by witnesses who are determined not to let him get away unpunished.
Camera, you're two-tier police.
Respect the police, guys.
Why are you running at me like I've done Christians, something?
Have
I done anything to you?
As you can see, things escalate, and the police are left with no choice. but to remove the individual who was involved in the incident. Contradicting narratives from the crowd are increasing ambiguity of the situation.
Please respect the officers. Please.
I would say
the officers know sort of their duties. Please, we need respect for them.
We do. This sort of thing is completely unnecessary. The BBC and the other media are ratcheting up hatred between groups. That's what they want, and they want this election to be about Muslims versus the rest. So these fights are set up. Actually, there's no need for arguments between religious groups. If I'm mayor, I would set up a committee of all religions to discuss anything they've got to make peace between religions. That's what we've got to have.
Admirable words, unfortunately, due to the great divide amongst the people and the conditioning of the public. Certain individuals will not be able to coexist, and that is sad. Now that police have detained one of the individuals, let's see what happens with the perpetrator who first resorted to physical violence and then attempted to flee the scene.
You see, he's making a fun. Bye-bye, where?
Where are you going? You assaulted someone.
Yes, you bastard. He did. He did. You scum liar.
At this point, this grown man starts to use vulgar language. Again, this is sad to see, but unfortunately, not an isolated incident.
What's your mother?
You're a coward.
Okay, my man.
Just lying about shit.
What's your mother? What's your mother?
He's gonna
screw you now. Hello! You running away, huh? You running away? Bye-bye, yes? Bye-bye. You will see bye-bye. No, we'll follow you until they catch you. They catch you. Him also, ladies and gentlemen. This the blue hooded scum. Yes. Yeah. It's him. He's going away. Him. Him. These three.
Hello, police.
Three of them.
Police.
Nothing. Don't worry, huh?
They're following you for a bit. They're going to be like, why is he following us?
Following you because you need to get arrested.
He's a faggot.
You've assaulted. You assaulted people. Come in anyway. We'll have you.
This guy's still on kids.
Yeah.
You
think you can get away? You assault people.
You just tell your friend to pick his jaw up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You get. So you admit it then? Yes.
He never touched him.
Yes, he did.
He never touched him.
You bastard. Yes, you did. You don't worry. We'll have you.
Go away, you Christian.
I'll have you. Don't worry, you bastard. Someone get him. Get the police.
Just when they thought they were about to get away, police finally turn up to detain the man. Let's keep watching.
Police!
This is the man. This one. Yes.
Him
and him as well.
I never touched him.
Yes, you did, you bastard. Where's the other one? This one as well. Say this one. Three of them.
Give us some room.
Three of them.
He didn't touch anybody.
Yes, he did. We have him.
Where's my phone?
What happened to you? You were laughing. He was laughing and running away.
He didn't touch no one.
Yes, he did. And you're the witness. He's the witness of it. You see, he's laughing. Come back, boys, come back.
Mr. M, you have to go by this letter, right? This man's been
No, no, he's making it up.
See, there you go.
No, no, no.
He's going to get his boys to stab him up.
No, he never said anything like that. You're making it up.
That's what you said. Listen.
No, he never said anything.
Why did you search a guy like me?
I'm a crackhead, yeah?
You have assaulted him as well.
See you soon, Bob. Enjoy yourself. Holy street man, Holy street man. Remember me? Yeah, I'm Holy street man. I'm gonna blow you away, Bob.
Oh, excuse me. Here we go.
No, he never said no.
He just made a threat to shoot me.
No, no, no.
Just give me a minute. Just give me a minute.
No.
That black man.
What did he say? What did he say? What did he say? Repeat it.
My fault.
Come back. Let the police do the job. Let the police do their job. Hello? You're interfering.
Gun threats. That guy's made gun threats.
Listen.
I'm trying to talk to my colleagues.
So you better raise your wings like that.
Listen, are you a lawyer? Are you a lawyer here? So stay back. Stay back. Let the police do the job.
Are you going to ignore gun violence?
Stay back. Don't. Stay back. Stay back. Let the police do their job. Hello?
There's some gun violence.
I can't stop myself from taking photos of cases, can I?
Listen and stay back. Stay back, let the police do their job.
Can't go around threatening to stab
even him.
Come from a religion of peace.
Yes, exactly.
Pathetic.
Can you just go away? It's a gun violence.
No, stay back, it's all right.
He said he's a street criminal.
I didn't say I was a street criminal. You're a tramp. Look at you.
He's made threats of gun violence.
Never.
Now he's threatening
you. You're making it up. You're making it up.
He's made threats of gun violence.
Him also. You, him.
That guy
him.
Has made threats of gun violence.
I ain't got a gun on me. Why would I have a gun on me?
Him.
Once the man is arrested, his buddies immediately get into a verbal tag of war. Allegations are thrown around in an attempt to avoid accountability. And at this point, officers detain an innocent bystander who was accused of making firearm-related threats by the man in blue hooded top.
I told him there is a law in this country, but he said,
can't even fucking speak English. Fuck off.
Oh, you can, yes?
A lot of people's time today.
All I was trying to do was
he said what?
Sir, go away. You can't recognize the situation.
No, but he was saying he said he could do anything he wanted, you see. But what happened to you? You're in the hand of the law, yes? The law is going to deal with you. He's never done that.
He didn't do anything.
He's done. He's okay. What makes you believe him, officer? What makes you believe him?
I'm not interested, mate.
What are you interested in? Tell me. What are you interested in? He's making up stories. It's been recorded. Thank you. Excuse me, what makes you believe that man?
What's your postcode?
What makes you to believe that man? What makes you to believe that man? That's what you need to ask.
He's just obviously made a threat to
war. Okay, do you believe that? Don't say anything, I'll answer for you. Leave it to me.
Have you seen a we just need to know what happens.
Yeah, I will tell you. Okay, what makes you... That's all right.
Okay? He's
giving me the permission. Are you giving... Wait, ma'am. No, you're giving me permission to talk for you, yes?
No.
What makes them to believe that man? That's what you need to ask.
Nobody's believing anything.
Because he's honest.
You're antagonizing the situation.
All right, get the information. Thank you. That's fine. Because he's honest, he's answering you.
Exactly. We haven't done anything.
Okay,
to what happened.
That's all right.
Person assault someone, and then verbally say something, yeah? Verbally threatening to stab someone. This isn't the first time. It's on YouTube. Pull it up.
Right, okay. Did you see any weapon at the time?
I didn't see any weapon, but when you come down for the second time in a week, you and your friends have done the same thing twice. You've been here, yeah? There's a YouTube video.
Yeah.
He's threatened someone.
Okay.
Come.
Alright.
Well, you can see, hasn't he? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. So he's free. You are not helping your own people here, sir.
We help everyone, sir.
No, you're not.
Yeah, we do.
How many weeks after week Christians peaceful getting assaulted there? And no police is coming for them. You see? There's so many video clips there. Week after week, you're doing nothing about it. And you're allowing these people easily walk.
Clearly these individuals are known to the police. Listen to what the officer says next.
There's not going to be any more problems since we go.
Well, he says
he's not going to cause any more problems.
No, he's not going.
None of us.
No, he's Christian. He's a peaceful Christian.
No, we're not in that state. I really do not like your statement, sir.
What statement?
You said you're not going to cause any more problem, are you? As if we caused a problem.
One moment. So how do you know? One moment. Leave it to me. So how do you know we caused problem? One moment. You see? When you find someone who's able to challenge you, that's what you quickly threaten them, yes? Earlier on. But why are you not answering?
I didn't threaten you at all, did I?
Yeah, but what makes you to say that we are troublemakers?
I said, when we leave here, there's not going to be any more problems, is there?
By whom?
By everyone. You,
no, we weren't the troublemakers here. But what happened to those guys?
They're gone now.
Why? So you let them go?
There was no allegations of age.
Yes!
So the first time allegations, it was just walked off.
No, he's in the park. He's in the park.
Come on, let's go.
At this point, it is not clear whether both individuals were arrested. What is clear is that freedom of expression comes with an element of responsibility. Yes, emotions can be overwhelming and lapses of judgment can occur. But at the end of the day, in order to coexist, we must learn to be better than this. Thank you for watching Audit Oblivion. If you found this video informative, leave us a like. And if you are new here, give us a follow.